Now, one of the things that I have learned about Hillary Clinton is that one of her heroes, her mentors, was Saul Alinsky. And her senior thesis was about Saul Alinsky. This was someone that she greatly admired and that affected all of her philosophies subsequently. Now, interestingly enough, let me tell you something about Saul Alinsky. He wrote a book called Rules for Radicals. On the dedication page, it acknowledges Lucifer, the original radical who gained his own kingdom. Now, think about that. This is a nation where our founding document, the Declaration of Independence, talks about certain inalienable rights that come from our Creator. This is a nation where our Pledge of Allegiance says we are one nation under God. This is a nation. This is a nation where every coin in our pocket and every bill in our wallet says, "In God we trust." So are we willing to elect someone as president who has as their role model somebody who acknowledges Lucifer? Think about that. The secular progressive agenda is antithetical to the principles of the founding of this nation. And if we continue to allow them to take God out of our lives, God will remove himself from us. We will not be blessed, and our nation will go down the tubes. And we will be responsible for that. We don't want that to happen.
You know, I don't know about you. Maybe some of the ladies out there know how I feel, but sometimes I feel like I've been asleep, you know? And I could never have fathomed that I would experience in my lifetime that a woman would become president. There are people around the world who think that this election is a joke. But you know what isn't a joke is your vote.
Does it have to come to a stop before?
Yeah, well, sometimes they don't want to, and they're, you know, Gaga, we can't get, you know, the frequency's weird, and, you know, it's sounding a little bit strange, and I'm like, if you don't get this right now, I swear to Lucifer, I'm gonna, you know, I get a little bit. If you don't get this right now, I swear to Lucifer, I'm gonna, you know, I get a little bit.
So here's how I'm going to use my voice. I'm going to vote for Hillary Clinton. That's right. I love Hillary, too. I have a couple of saved messages on my phone from HRC.
What was going on in my life at 15, and that's how I got introduced to the music industry. I swear I wanted to be like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
Because the soul is colorless. Our soul is colorless. And I want to grow up in a world where my daughter has no limitation, where our daughter has no limitations. She feel like she can be whatever she want to be in the world. And this other guy, I don't have any ill will towards him, but his conversation is divisive, and that's not an evolved soul to me, so he cannot be my president. And without further ado, I would like to introduce to you the next president of the United States, Ms. Hillary Clinton.
H to the Izzo, V to the Izzy, Jehovah God. That's what he calls himself. He believes that he is God, and he believes that Jesus Christ is not the Son of God. He believes that the black man is God. His clothing line is called Rockaware. Those are his clothes. You can't even go into a... I mean, I have a hard time shopping for clothes now, Brother Dwayne. But this is Jay-Z, and he had an album called The Black Album, and of course these guys release songs, you know, underground, and they do this kind of stuff, and we just happened to come across a very disturbing song by Brother Jay-Z. It's a song that he actually recorded and has a backwards message in it, and we had to reverse the song and play the song backwards to get this message for you. Y'all remember back when the heavy metal folks used to do that? And they would put the backwards max messages in their music, and they'd say that your subconscious was smart enough, that right brain was smart enough to decode and flip that message, so by the time it got to the left side of your brain, you understood it, and you didn't even know you understood it. You just acted it out. Because they had the song called Another One Bites the Dust Queen. Played it backwards. It said, I like to smoke marijuana. Yeah, and then they interviewed kids, and kids said when they listened to it, they just want to get high. They just want to smoke weed, and they had no idea that that message was being reversed in their minds and causing them to want to do that. Isn't that weird? God made us smart. Look at somebody say, you smart? So I don't care what they say about you. I'm going to let y'all hear it. Can I let y'all hear it? Listen.
666. Murder, Jesus.
Six, 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 murder, Jesus.
Really need a word. Growing up a pyramid, it's all Illuminati. Now I'm damn it.
that they do bring. Just check the left hand, see the G-ring. And mock rituals, what are they unleashing? Masonic rituals, live on TV. It's all been exposed, like Versace clothes. Just like MK Ultra, it's on my control. You tripping when you ain't sipping, have a refill. You feeling like you in prison, huh? That's cause that's real.
But you know what? It is not about Donald Trump. It is not about me. It is about we the people. And Thomas Jefferson said that we would reach this point because we the people would not be paying attention, and it would allow the government to grow, to expand, and to metastasize, and to try to rule us. But he said, before we turn into something else, we the people would recognize what was going on, what we were about to lose, and we would rise up and we would take control of our nation. And I say now is the time for us to rise up and take America back.
Hearing on the floor, what, I don't think she embraces Lucifer. I think that this was just a, and then they would go on with their explanation. Why so heavy-handed trying to tie Hillary Clinton to Lucifer?
Well, first of all, recognize that this is a very famous book, Rules for Radicals. And on the dedication page, you acknowledge Lucifer in an admirable way.
Right.
Saying that he's the original radical who gained his own kingdom.
Right.
And then if you read the book, I don't know if you've ever read it.
Right. What I did was I read the studies of the book just to figure out where you were going with this. But right. Please continue.
But please read the book. Because it's very interesting how it uses controlled anarchy
right.
in order to change us from a democratic republic to a socialist society.
Right.
And I don't think that those things are consistent with the principles and the basis of this nation.
Right, but you seem contextually to make it like Hillary Clinton's carrying it around in her back pocket. It's something she mentioned in 1969 in a thesis.
Well, here's the point. We all have people who are our mentors. We all have people that we admire. As a college student at Wellesley, she was on a first-name basis with Saul Alinsky. He offered her a job after she finished, but she decided to go to law school. They were very close. You look at some of the letters. But I also had a mentor. It was my mother. And, you know, she had a difficult upbringing, but she never let me be a victim. And the person that I am today has a lot to do with who I admire and who is my role model.
You also said in this campaign many times, don't judge me, Ben Carson, by my worst moments from 100 years ago. And you've many times contextualized criticisms of you as saying, was that? How long ago was that that I said that? Why can't you judge me on what's going on now? You do not give Hillary Clinton the benefit of that analysis.
Well, actually, I do, because you know, in the real world, and particularly in business, if someone is doing something that is inappropriate, what you do is you maybe give them remedial training or you demote them. Here we have a situation where you had a person who was the first lady, who was a United States Senator, who was the Secretary of State, who doesn't have the knowledge or the judgment to treat classified information or even to understand what it is in an appropriate way that doesn't jeopardize the country. And instead of sending her for remedial training and demoting her, you're saying, let's promote her to the highest position in the land.
Legitimate argument, certainly different than blaming her for what she wrote in college. That's why I'm asking you. I get that Lucifer is a powerful term, especially with a group that is faith sensitive. But do you feel that it was going too far in retrospect?
Again, when you look at the principles that are espoused by Christ, by Christianity, and you look at what's espoused by evil, and then you look at things like killing babies, you look at things like redefining marriage away from what the biblical definition is, I think there's pretty good consistency there.